Good morning. A beautiful start to the day. We had a lot of cloud cover yesterday, but not the case today. We'll see a lot of sunshine as we head through the 9 o'clock hour. Temperatures nice and comfortable, 275 degrees as we head toward the lunch hour. Climbing quickly, though, a muggy 87 and then topping back out at 93 degrees this afternoon and feeling a little bit hotter than that with the moisture around. Late today, there will be a slight chance for an isolated thunderstorm after 5 o'clock, but chance is a little slimmer for us than what we saw yesterday. 70 degrees right now, relative humidity at 51%, so still we do have that moisture around to perhaps get a stray shower, thunderstorm going later on, but nothing really to talk about right now. Skies mainly clear with the exception of the Sacramentos. We have some light showers moving out of there. Later on this afternoon as we head toward the lunch hour, mountain storms will develop and we'll be looking at more spot activity across the east central plains. I'll have the details in your region by region forecast coming up.
A student sentenced in today's Tuesday Morning News Blitz. A University of New Mexico graduate student popped last year for dealing prescription pills will spend the next 8 months in jail. 26-year-old Paul DeSantis was a pharmacy intern at UNM Hospital when drug agents busted him for stealing prescription paper, then forging prescriptions for oxycodone to resell. Thomas Hancock is charged with first-degree murder. Police say he shot Joseph Threadgill 7 times Saturday night at TD Show Club after he was thrown out. Yesterday, a judge increased Hancock's bond to $100,000 cash only. Crews have been working to protect the new Bandelier National Monument Visitor Center from floodwaters by lining the building with sandbags. But because it's so expensive to wrap and unwrap the building, the park says it could be years before the visitor center reopens. Obama administration officials will get a first-hand look today at the devastation from Hurricane Irene. They'll survey the damage and recovery efforts in Virginia, North Carolina, and Vermont, which was especially hard hit. And Prince Harry is trading the wet weather across the pond for some hot western weather. The younger prince will train at 2 U.S. military bases in California and Arizona starting in early October. And that about does it for your Tuesday morning headlines.